In the last video, I am explaining about datum point. In that video, I told about insert point, cursor location, exit point, endpoint. These four options I already told. If you not yet watch the part one video, you just go and watch, then come back to this video, so you can understand easy. So in this video, I will explain the remaining commands how to use. Okay, I just go to the UG. The same window, same object. Last video I used. I just open. Okay, let's go to the next command. Insert datum point. The fourth one is datum point. I just click to the fifth option, control point. This command used for you can create point on any curve or any edge, but you can create 3 points only. For example, you can create start point, midpoint, and end point. You can create 3 points only. You cannot create points on surface. You can create edge point only. Okay, let's move on to the next option. I just reset, then I go to the next option, intersection point. The intersection point means you can create the datum point between one object and one curve. For example, I just make one curve and I will explain. In this 3D, I already have one datum coordinate system, right? So I use this plane. I just make one sketch. Use this plane. Let's see. I go to the insert toolbar command, then go to sketch in dask environment. Already have one plane, right? So I select existing plane. So I just click this plane XY, then click OK. I just make one line. Okay, then right click, finish sketch. So just rotate the curve and this object will meet, right? So you can create point on this meeting point. Okay, I go to the insert toolbar, datum point, the fourth option. I just click, so intersection point. So select object means you first select the object, then select the curve. So the point will come here, right? So this option used for you can create datum point between two objects like curve and one object. Okay, let's move on to the next command. Next one, arc, ellipse, sphere, send. While you doing a modeling, if you want center point of arc, ellipse, cylinder, you can use this option. For example, I just make one arc. I will explain how to make this. Cancel and go to the sketch option. I just create arc on this face. So I select this face. I select infer and select this face. Okay. Just make random arc. Just random arc. Then right click, finish sketch. So if I want center point of this arc, I can use this insert datum point option. I can create the fourth one option, datum point. So I just click this arc. I can create, wait a minute, I just go to the arc option, then I just click this arc. I can create the center point of this arc. So this is similar for ellipse and sphere. Okay, thank you. Next, we go to the next option. The next one option is arc, angle on arc. Okay, I just make new arc. I will explain how to make this. Go to the insert, then click curve. The second one option is arc. So I just make random arc using 3 points, 1, 2, 3. Okay, then click OK. This is just a random arc. Okay, I'm going to the datum point option. Insert datum point. So angle on arc. So this option used for if I just create one datum point, I can move this point along this curve use the angle value. For example, the point is here, so I can move use that angle. For example, I just give 5 angle, so the datum point will move along this curve using that angle 15 degree, 20 degree, 45 degree, 50 degree, 70 degree, like that. So the datum point will move along this curve is that angle. Okay, let's move on to the next option. The next one is quadrant point. For example, here have one cylinder, you can create 4 points on cylinder. I just make one cylinder. I will explain how to make this. So I go to insert, design feature, the fourth one, cylinder. Wherever you want, you can create. I just use this edge point. I just make one cylinder vector. I just click this vector. I want this direction, then I click this point. So cylinder will come this direction. Cylinder diameter 50, height 100, just give the random value. Okay, just one cylinder came right. Then I go to the insert datum point option. Okay, I just reset and go to quadrant point. This command used for you can create 4 points on one circle, like 90 degree, 90 degree, 2, 3, 4. You can create 4 points only. You cannot create points on that surface. You can create 4 points on that circle. Okay, thank you. I go to the next option. Then next one is point and curve. This command used for you can create the datum point on any curve or any edge at any point. If I want here, I can just click here, wherever I want, I can create along this curve. So this also same for edge. The edge point you can create anywhere. You can create new datum point. Okay, thank you. Let's move on to the next option. Just reset and go to next one, point and face. So this command used for you can create datum point on any face. I just create one face. I will explain how to make this. I just click this curve, then control T for transform. Just move 320 350, then click OK. I just copy this curve. So I'm going to create new surface using these two lines. So I'm just going to insert, then click mesh surface, throw curves, ruled, second one throw curves. So I just click first one curve, then click add new set, then click you can create new surface using these two arc. Okay, let's go to the datum point, insert datum point. So point and face. So this command used for you can create point on this face anywhere you want. Just click, you can create new point. If I want here, I just click, it will create here. So anywhere you want, you can create. Okay, let's move on next option. Just reset. Between 2 points. This is for you can create datum point between 2 points. For example, I just click this edge at this edge, I can create center one datum point. For example, I just click here and here, so I can create center one datum point. If I want move, I can move. Now is the 50% right? I want move 75%, I can move 10%, I can move. Okay, this similar to the datum layer option. Okay, So datum point option, all comments are finished. So thank you for watching. Please subscribe my channel. We will meet on next video. Thank you. Bye.